Sushma Swaraj, as External Affairs Minister, ever since she came under this problem, she's been trying to have her say inside the parliament. But the opposition, united opposition, was not allowing, giving her this liberty. So now that the opposition is out of parliament, almost the entire opposition, barring one or two smaller parties, so she got her chance and she had her say. But I would say that, you know, politics is not just about being involved in criminal activities. It has also got a lot to do with your personal things, ethics, morality. So a lot of situations, you know, come where you have to be, politicians are required to have a high moral standard than the common people. Sushma did say what she wanted to say. She did try to come out of the logjam, and she did try and make an effort to say that she had not helped Lalit Modi in any which way. But I don't think that that has cut any ice with the opposition, because the Congress has already said that whatever Sushma ji has said in Parliament today, that is not a proper response, and nothing short of our resignation is going to bring the Parliament back into a functioning mode. As somebody covering the Parliament, I am happy about is the fact that, you know, Sushma ji had been trying to say, have her say inside Parliament, and even without the opposition being there, she did manage to have that, have her way today, and that is one thing out of the way now. So now I think the government should make an effort to try and reach out to the opposition and bring them back to the negotiation table, so that, you know, parliament can actually work, and not just, you know, it cannot be a one-way street with only the NDA allies and some minor non-NDA parties being inside the house.
मैं पूछना चाहती हूँ, क्या मैंने ललित मोदी को कोई आर्थिक लाभ पहुँचाया? नहीं. क्या मैंने ललित मोदी को भारत से भगाया? नहीं. क्या मैंने ललित मोदी के खिलाफ चल रही जांच को रुकवाया? नहीं. क्या मैंने ललित मोदी को यात्रा दस्तावेज दिलवाने का अनुरोध किया? नहीं. तो मैंने किया क्या? ललित मोदी की पत्नी पिछले 17 वर्षों से कैंसर से पीड़ित है. 10वीं बार उसका कैंसर उभरा था. 10वीं बार वो पुर्तगाल के एक क्लिनिकल सेंटर, जो रिसर्च सेंटर है, उसमें इलाज करवा रही थी. वहां उसका असेसमेंट करने के बाद डॉक्टरों ने कहा कि इस बार का आपका कैंसर लाइफ थ्रेटनिंग है. मेरी जगह आप होती, आप क्या करती? मैं कहती हूं, अगर मेरी जगह कोई नहीं, सोनिया जी होती, तो क्या करती? मरने के लिए छोड़ देती? ये इतना बड़ा मानवीय संवेदना का केस है, जहां ललित मोदी की मदद नहीं हुई, मदद उस पत्नी की हुई जो भारतीय नागरिक है, जो किसी अपराध में लिप्त नहीं है, जिसके खिलाफ कोई केस देश या विदेश में नहीं चल रहा है, जो 17 वर्षों से कैंसर से पीड़ित है, और जो इलाज कराने जा रही है वो इलाज खतरों से भरा है. इसलिए वो ये चाहती है कि उसका पति उस दिन अस्पताल में मौजूद हो, उसे भावनात्मक संबल देने के लिए भी, और ये निर्णय करने के लिए भी कि एक ट्रीटमेंट आगे किया जाए या ना किया जाए. अध्यक्ष जी, इस चीज को सामने रखकर मैंने ये कहा कि अगर ब्रिटिश सरकार निर्णय करती है उसको यात्रा दस्तावेज देने का, तो हम दोनों देशों के रिश्ते खराब नहीं होंगे. और मैं पूछना चाहती हूं आपसे कि इस तरह की महिला की मदद करना यदि गुनाह है, तो मैं कहना चाहती हूं कि यह गुनाह मैंने किया है, और अध्यक्ष जी, आपको साक्षी मानकर इस सदन में खड़े होकर पूरे राष्ट्र के सामने मैं अपना यह गुनाह कबूल करती हूं, और यह सदन इसके लिए मुझे जो सजा देना चाहे, मैं वो भुगतने के लिए तैयार हूं.
What happened, this so-called Naga agreement was, I thought it was an ambush by the government in trying to deflect attention, because even today, 4 days after the accord, there is no clarity on what the accord is. Was there actually an accord, or it's just, you know, two people talking to each other? Whereas everybody knows that this group with which the Prime Minister happily posed and got himself photographed and made these loud noises, also talking to all the opposition leaders on the phone the same evening. The government has been talking to this group for the past so many years. what should have been done is to make public what is the give and take in this. So I think you know, by doing this in such a unilateral way, without possibly even involving the Home Ministry, because that's what we have been told, that the entire Home Ministry was kept in the dark. So the government has only, you know, created one more problem for itself. And when Mrs. Gandhi today, when she said that the Congress chief ministers would not accept that, the accord or whatever it is, you know, she has no idea what the accord is. And also, you know, BJP came to power on the promise of having a more inclusive federal structure. So Prime Minister Modi, if he wanted to, you know, take this thing forward, he should have spoken to the states, the chief ministers of the states, that would eventually be either benefit or, you know, have some kind of negative reaction from this accord.